really, really sorry, but the question will be for tomorrow. So keep up, and we'll have now the last speaker. Thank you, Miles. The last speaker is Dr. Gennady Finkelstein, the founder of GenCell, and he will talk still about alkaline fuel cell, but from another perspective.
Good morning or good afternoon. I asked to be in frame of 15 minutes. I will try to do it, but I have a presentation and I hope you will like it. And I will start and will complete this presentation according scheduled by myself. So a few words about our company, our technology, our unique technology related to use of ammonia fuel. And short summary, it will be today in my presentation. So GenCell founded in 2011. We are not big, but not small company. We are 86 people in nice building. I think, I don't know how to use it. Please help me. Okay, thank you. So we are 86 people located in a nice building called Petah Tikva and worldwide distribution network around the world. I'm not good with... Oh, so today, after 7 years of company was established, we reached very, very important milestones. Probably it sounds very... loud, but I strongly believe what today, and we will see it later, we are best AFC technology in the world, in the market, because we have commercial products already deployed in 9 countries around the world, working already more than 2 years. And our first ammonia-based alkaline fuel cells, already week number 5, running in Japan, and our first customers, fully automated without presence of team. Okay, so it's provided me a lot of confidence to tell what I am telling you now. So our fuel cells technology, it's alkaline, as mentioned today. We are not membrane-based, we are liquid alkaline fuel cells, which have some kind of advantages and have such kind of disadvantages. Nobody perfect in this world. So a core of our technology, I hope I will manage this. A core of our technology is a fuel cells module. You can see on the right side because I don't know how to put a pointer. I was not trained. Okay. So it's our fuel cells module, which have three main circuits, liquid electrolyte, which come to KOH chamber between anode and cathode, air supply to air chamber, or hydrogen supply to hydrogen chamber, and air supply to air chamber. So this is how this fuel cell stack look for, and this is part of our production facility, and this is our team. So this is how it's generator designed. It's our first commercial generator, 5 kilowatts. So electrolyte stored in the electrolyte tank. When a system going to operation, electrolyte pump circulate electrolyte between the electrodes. It's like a heart and human being body, and electrolyte like a blood, which is circulating. We have regenerative scrubber, 2 parts of scrubber, 1 part is cleaning air from CO2, it absorbs CO2, and second part dissolves CO2, so we change air flow. So air coming from the environment, pass cleaning in this box, come to the fuel cells, make a walk, and after that come into to dirty part and disorbit. This is how it's work. So it's provide us ability with, to clean air without to deal with any separators and filters. These fuel cell stacks. We have electronics and algorithm. So mostly we have a blood, it's our electrolyte, we have a cart, with our pump, we need air, we need fuel, we have a brain, our electronics and algorithms, we produce energy, and even for we make a byproduct, pee, like a water, like a human being. So today, this is our status today, our G5, with our first commercial product, hydrogen-based, for backup power application, already deployed more than 2 years. Our second, it's mostly same product, which in special shelter, which we designed to be for utilities application. Our first units will be deployed in December this year. This is the first fuel cell system which received seismic certification in the United States, and we are deployed in seismic zone in California. Next year we will deploy it in Mexico. This is our ammonia-based fuel cell, which I hope by end of next year will be brought to commercial level. Today is pilot level. And this is my dream, transportation, which was so many discussion today. But to make it happen for such small company like us, we need significant resources. So meantime, it's still dream, and we are working very hard to make what from the dream we will come to some kind of real action. So our next step, look at this picture. One of six people in the world today live without electricity. Honestly, I think more than one per six people around the world will living in very, very poor grid environment. Energy demand increased by 25% planning by 2040. It's like another additional North and Latin America. In 85% of electricity demand grow from developing nations. So this is what happened today. And energy puzzle is already, let's say, completed by using battery technologies, wind generators, and different power converters. But I can tell you what, in many areas in the world, unfortunately, people never will have access to the renewable energy. Monsoons, you have no sun. Jungles, you have no wind. And governments will not put any investments in grid infrastructure. So we will, even with all nice campaign which happened today, say no to diesel, diesel will still dominate in these areas. It's only solution. So to complete this puzzle, we need to put most difficult piece, it's hydrogen energy solution, which include fuel cell systems and hydrogen infrastructure. Today, in previous presentation from speakers from Japan and Germany, we saw massive investment in hydrogen infrastructure. Okay? Massive investment and targets to be 400 hydrogen fuel stations in Germany in coming years. For such big country, what's mean 400 hydrogen fuel cell stations with such huge investment? So hydrogen infrastructure, not fuel cells, this is a major issue for expansion of hydrogen energy solutions. So ammonia. widely used in agriculture, comes in form of liquid, not gas, close to 200 million ton ammonia produced today annually. It's everywhere, transportation, logistic regulation available. So, and look for the energy storage density, ammonia stored at 8 bar, 15 degrees Celsius, close to 120 grams of hydrogen per liter. I will not spend time for gas, hydrogen gas, and even for 700 bar. Let's come to liquid hydrogen, minus 253 C, cryogenics, 70 plus gram of hydrogen per liter, to compare to close to 120 ammonia. So ammonia is perfect hydrogen carrier. And it can be solution to bypass, to overcome hydrogen infrastructure issues, at least not in full segment, in several segments related to hydrogen economy. And when ammonia fuel is used in the fuel cells, its additional benefits, absence of CO2 emission, for example, it's cheap and it's worldwide available. And today, no modern country can have economy without use of ammonia. Every country, Israel, United States, Germany, I don't know, Senegal, Pakistan, everybody use ammonia today. And alkaline fuel cells is ideally to run on ammonia, since the alkaline nature of NH3 does not damage alkaline fuel cells like ACID technology, for example, proton exchange membrane based. Okay, so our first A5 units, A5 it's ammonia, 5 it's 5 kilowatt, targeted for mainly for off-grid application, pure grid application. And this is some examples when one tank of ammonia, 3 ton, can supply before loses 6.5 megawatt hour of electric and thermal energy. So this is, I cannot disclose name of the company we are working in Japan. I cannot show any pictures, but I decided to share with you because honestly it's a big achievement and big proud of our company. Our first pilot, which ran today in case of acceptance test in north of Japan, outdoor, without presence of our people and fully automatic regime. So of course we are monitoring this system from outside. So this is ammonia tanks, ammonia storage, ammonia gas come to ammonia cracking unit when we achieving 700 degrees Celsius and we decompose ammonia gas to hydrogen and nitrogen, it's gas mixture. We call it walking gas, 75% of hydrogen, 25% of nitrogen. This hydrogen mixture of walking gas, without any filters, without any membranes, without any cleaning, come to our electrochemical generator or alkaline fuel cells. So hydrogen make a job to provide DC power to the cost, to the load. But we cannot consume all hydrogen, so purge gas, when we have 25% of hydrogen and 75% of nitrogen, come back to the ammonia cracking unit. Hydrogen is perfect fuel. It helps us to keep thermal balance, to keep temperature, and nitrogen with some heat and water vapor coming back to the atmosphere. So next step, so I told you about my dream about transportation. One more dream, which we are working hard to make it happen, dream of green ammonia. Today, 1.8% of the global first fossil energy goes into ammonia production. It's contribute almost to 3% of CO2 emission in the world. That means ammonia production is not nice in case of environmental. But ammonia, in the air we have nitrogen and hydrogen. And today it was also, especially by speaker, in 2 minutes finish, it's already coming to end. Already a speaker in Germany told about huge hydrogen production by using electrolyzers. So, using renewable energy to have hydrogen and to take nitrogen from the air, it's standard technology. To synthesize ammonia on the place, mini ammonia power plants, which can provide ammonia to different uses, not necessary for energy, for agriculture, for industry, and of course, to Jensel fuel cell system, which is next step, logic step, which we need to think how to start to deploy it. So, green ammonia, perfect energy storage, independent from natural gas and fossil fuel, and work beautiful with renewable energies such as solar or wind. So this road of distribution power, it's our roadmap. 2016, first commercial F5 unit was deployed. December this year, second product for utilities, certified to be on commercial, to be in a seismic zone and to work under high voltage lines. Ammonia hopefully will come by end of next year, first commercial. This depends not only on us and our ability to raise the money. Same ammonia tank, green ammonia. Honestly, time is our big enemy. We are a small private company, live for private money. Investors never patient, and time is our enemy. I think we achieved great results, and now it's time to run. So we are going to run no matter what. Thank you.